seeing some faces.
I was there for 1 month.
And all the things I've told as many people that care to listen since I came back on the 1st of this month. Most of the things you read about on the social media are being exaggerated. And that is not to exonerate the government that they are not doing what they are supposed to do. But you can trust Nigerians. Nigerians are resilient. They are a different, I always tell people, God is actually a Nigerian. God is a Nigerian. Because if not that God is a Nigerian, God loves Nigeria, that country will not even be in existence as we speak. But the mercy of God has been keeping that country. And please, I just want to encourage us that please don't join the people who want the nation down. I'm not saying we don't have problems. We have challenges. But let us continue to prophesy positive things into that nation. And God will answer our prayers over the nation.
Amen.
Every day I have the facts too. I have facts about oil bunkering. I have facts about those who steal our oil and they sell it on the open seas and so on. But God is fighting the battle. And I believe God that between now and next year, we will see God doing things that none of us can imagine can be done. God will deliver Nigeria from the hands of the evil ones in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So I just want us to be hopeful. Let us continue to prophesy good things. I was in Lagos for 1 month. Yes, we had our hold-ups, we had our challenges, but at the same time, you could see that things are getting better and better. And that's why we need to pray that God will touch every heart in Nigeria and every heart of every Nigerian all over the world to turn our heart of stone to heart of flesh. I told them when I got to, I said, if every one of us wakes up every morning and you say, I'm going to work today, I'll go and earn my salary and help my fellow man be, within 1 month, Nigeria will change. So it's not only the problem of those up there. Everybody down there too are on the make. Apart from the few who still have the fear of God in their hearts, and those few are making a difference. You know, I got to the airport, and somebody said he wanted to help me to push my things out. I said, okay, no problem. And as I said, okay, you have something to give to the immigration. I said, I don't have anything to give to you. Why? I've not brought in drugs. My goods passed through the conveyor belt. No, I mean, I didn't carry anything. So when I got there, I just said to them, I said, you know what? I won't give you a penny. Because you are the first set of people a visitor will see. You are the people who will either sell Nigeria or destroy Nigeria. And I said something to all those guys. I said, all of you here, so people will kill to get the jobs you are having. And you are being paid well. So be contented with whatever you have. Don't destroy this country. You know, by the time I finished talking to them, none of them will ask me for a cover. And I said to them, can I pray for you? And then they looked at me and said, I gave a pass. I said, I will raise some. So I prayed for them. And I prayed that Nigeria will be good. So every one of us have a responsibility. So it is not enough for us to say, I want Nigeria or sugar. Nigerians are this. Nigeria is this. You and I are the Nigerians. So if you make your own difference, I make my own difference, we touch lives, we touch people with the way we do things, we see that people will start changing. I was there for 1 month. I didn't pay anybody one dime as bribe. And I went to do a lot of things that people should ask me for bribe. But I tell them, if you do something and I'm impressed with you, I will give you something. Number two, confess positive things. Number three, play your part in putting things right. And we see a better Nigeria by this time next year in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, the King of glory, the Lord of hosts and Ancient of Days, we have come together as a nation. We have come together as a community to say thank you for the 62nd anniversary of the independence of Nigeria. Father, we are grateful that Nigeria is still standing. We are grateful that Nigeria is still existing as a nation. In spite of a myriad of problems, we are grateful. Father, please accept our gratitude in Jesus' name. Father, as we celebrate, we also bring repentance for all the sins that we have all committed, and even our forefathers, that has brought us to this stage where we are. Father, please have mercy. Temper your justice with mercy. Please forgive Nigeria. Please wash that nation clean in the blood of Jesus, and deliver us from all the atrocities that we have committed, that have been committed, and that we yet be committed. Father, please put a stop to all evil things in that nation, and continue to expose, disgrace, and destroy everyone that says they will not repent from their evil doings in that nation. Between now and next year, between now and the time they will have their so-called election, Father Lord, we pray that visit your Nigeria with your judgment and mercy. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Father, we also pray for the Nigerian All-Stars in Oxina, who are the unifying factor bringing all Nigerians together, that Lord will continue to be with them, grant them wisdom, knowledge, and understanding to continue to propagate Nigeria in a positive light. In Jesus' name we have prayed. So in the name of God the Father, and of God the Son, and of God the Holy Spirit, we declare this wonderful gathering open to the glory of God the Father. For in Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen. A round of applause for Pastor Tokugo in Bilgwe. I told you, that man is vast in everything. I tell you, biblically he's vast, historically he's vast. Name it, anything is very vast. And very, very comprehensive.
One morning we go to your nominated beneficiaries, and your justice will pass on the bodies to your beneficiaries as well. Divided. Let me give you an example. For example, I take a life insurance policy, £500,000. That's the value. Maybe I pay.
Here, we are always positive. One oh, yes. Nigeria. God bless you, my brother. You're welcome, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you once again to this wonderful occasion.
Please, may we put our hands together for the organizers of this wonderful event. If you're not clapping, I'll ask you why. This day, a round of applause, please. Now we're here. A round of applause for Nigeria. Round of applause for Africa. Round of applause for us. A round of applause for the whole of the land. A round of applause for the UK. Mr. Kevin, a round of applause for Africa. Wonderful. DJ Sonny, round of applause. Thank you for organizing this. Going for food is that table and that table at the moment. So all the escorts, please come forward.
Nice SC, please can you come forward please? We are one.
photographer here, please. The photographer. Where's the flag this way?
Thank you.
can see what happened here. I can see. Anymore who's out? Two chairs out.
Grace, a round of applause for Grace. She did wonderfully well. But there has to be a winner. Thank you very much.
active role in community development and support for NAS SC is the person of Mr. Wilfred Lasso. Are you here, Mr.
Wilfred Lasso? Give him a clap offering. As a champion, community champion, thank you for all your good work. Yes. You've always been there. Today you were starting from the nice man. He's in charge of VOA. If you want to use on your computer to find out what happened, you ask Frank. Thank you, Mr. Frank.
Yes, sir.
Good work.
Everybody having a great time.
He's very good with football. And he's always supporting us, giving us uncounted amounts of money all the time that we need him. Thank you, Dr. Ibrahim, for the good work. NAS would not be the same without you. Thank you, sir. We recognize the good things you've been doing for us. Thank you for all the motherly support.
Okay, DJ, let's get this rock going.
Yes, let's get this rock going.